I'm gonna do a review on the Diva Cup. My period is like clockwork, it's happening right now. So I got the number one because I haven't had any kids yet, and this is the size for women under 30 years old who has never delivered vaginally or by C-section. So I'm going to try this. I'm not gonna stand up, because if I stand up, you're gonna see my vagina. So I've watched a review on this. Okay, this camera is sliding, so I need to find a good spot. Okay, I'm not getting up like this. So I'm opening the box. Okay, it's a nice little baggie. Oh, it's cute, whatever, it's cute. Nice little baggie for the Diva Cup. I think that's where you put it in. You put the cup in after you've used it for it to hang out and chill for a month. Okay. So, I'm gonna hopefully edit all of this. Direction, pictures, okay, I already kind of know I'm not going to read all of this, I probably should, but I'm going to wash my hands first because I just ate a cookie, and I don't really want cookies on there, so I'm going to wash my hands. Okay, I figured it out, I put it in my closet, in my bathroom, like I said, my hands are clean. The review that I watched, just touched my hair. Okay. I think I'm supposed to hold it like this. It's not that bad. It would be like really stiff. Not really stiff. Like this. Like that. There's one you can see. I'm gonna do this. Thank you, lady. I'm gonna put your name on here. So I have some tissue in there just blocking, so I'm gonna do this, okay? Okay, I'm gonna wash it and try it again. Yeah, you're supposed to rinse it before you put it in your vagina, by the way. Didn't do that, but it didn't go in, so. Okay, I have to wash my hands. I don't feel anything. Okay. Now, I don't feel disgusted. Because I was on the NuvaRing before, and I'm used to, I know it might sound gross, but inserting and taking things out of my body. So, just trying to clean up the area. I am going to wear, I can't feel anything. Okay, if I push down, I can feel it. So I hope it's in there. To push down, so I won't twist it. I feel like it's twisted. I'm attempting to straighten it and push up, but I can feel a stem of it. I can feel the stem of it, so I don't know. I am just gonna wear panty liners for tonight. I should probably do a full on pad, but I don't wear pads, so I'm gonna have to use the next best thing I have, panty liners. So therefore, we're going to try this. I don't have those stylish period panties. I just have regular black underwear, you know. All right. this is day one. Day one of, day one of the Diva Cup. Yes. I'm going to read the instructions more after I've inserted it. Probably shouldn't do that. And, yeah. See you tomorrow. I'm not going to take this out until tomorrow. It feels kind of weird. But I don't know if that's period cramps or I have something in me cramps. We'll see. Good morning, everybody. It is somewhere close to 6. Somewhere close to 6:40. Last night was okay. I have 0 leaks on the panty liner. I did put a little tissue in there just for my own mental stability. You know, nothing. There was no leaks. But I'm cramping like crazy. That doesn't help. So I'm gonna take this out, rinse it, and then I took everything off my bathroom floor. So just in case, I can just wipe it. But I think I'm gonna take it off over the toilet. So here I go. Yes, I washed my hands. Can't get it because it's like slippery, but I'm gonna try. I have no nails and I can't get it. Okay. Okay, you guys. It's so. Like, I have no nails. I don't want to show you the hands that I'm using. But I have no nails. So I can't get the freaking stem. So I'm pushing. You know, you're about to poop. I'm pushing and it's like coming out. But it's still slipping. So. Dang. I pushed it up too far. Definitely pushed it up too far. Whew. Okay. And I have no nails. So it's hard. The suction is incredible because I cannot get it out. Okay. It's out. It's like coming and I'm pulling, but it's 4 minutes. It's work. I'm going to get it on this try though. Okay. Good net. I'm going to show it. Come on, that's a lot. Lot of blood for one thing. Oh my god. Okay, I'm gonna hurry up and put it back in. Rinse it and put it back in. There's nothing. Just. There's nothing. There's just blood. Literally thick blood. Huh. Okay, I'm gonna stop drawing. Okay. I'm pouring it in the toilet. Okay. I'm not gonna put it up far anymore. That far. Nope, because that shit took me for that. Excuse me.
That's good.
I didn't push it up far. Like I said, guys, I'm cramping so bad. Why are you? I'm cramping so bad. Okay, I didn't put it in. I can, like, feel it. I did not push it up far. It's right there, which is fine because I'm not about to take forever taking it out of me. Oh. Dude, I don't think my body likes that. French. Okay. It wasn't too bad. It's not going to clean up. It wasn't terrible. It took me a whole 7 minutes. Only because it took me forever to get it out. For the first time, and I've learned not to put it up too far. I gotta take some right off. I can't do it. But, yeah, I'm probably not going to let it stay in for 6 hours, especially on the first day, because, I mean, not 6 hours, 12 hours, because that was in for 6 hours, and that was a lot. So, I will be taking it out in another six more hours, which is going to be at work. So, I don't know if I'm going to film it, but I'll try. Okay. Bye. Okay, I'm going to push it up some more, because when I'm walking, I can feel it. So I don't think it's up far enough. It's like no blood. Like no blood left around. Nothing. I thought I would have like blood all over my hands. It would be a blood fest. Red wedding number 3. Yeah.
hasn't been a two, but Red Wedding.
All over again.
But no. No, not at all. Very limited blood. When you're changing it. I did it over the toilet. Well, I took it out over the toilet. I don't think I've gotten it down packed yet. Like, you know, taking it out, putting it in, taking it out. But, you know, it's not horrible.
Good morning. So I am on my way to church. Day number three. So yesterday I tried to do, was the longest. I had the Diva cup inserted. I had it in from like when I vlogged earlier in the morning, I think, at like 8 o'clock until 3, around 3. Now, I didn't have any spotting in the first couple hours, well, until about the end. And then I was like, okay, I need to go and take this out. I had a little bit of spotting, and then once I changed it, I kept it in there until the night. And then last night, I had a lot of bleeding. Escaped the cup, so I don't know what happened. Either I didn't put it in there right. I'm still trying to figure out my foot inserting technique to make sure like it's in there correct. There is still blood in the cup. Not as much as the first day. But there is still blood in the cup, but then there's blood escaping some way, somehow, I don't know how. So yeah, last night was a lot of blood that escaped. However, I did have I used a panty liner, and that was good enough, I think. I don't think it was kind of messy. But it didn't get on my pants or in my pajamas or anything, so it was not that messy. That's it. Nothing else. Like I said, I'm still working on my inserting technique and making sure like it's there. No cramp. Yesterday was just cramping all day, which is the normal for me. The first 2 days are just really heavy with cramps and stuff like that. But today I'm feeling good. I'm feeling better. So I'm gonna give it another try. I'm gonna keep doing this until I get it right. So it's either Diva cup or nothing. Well, I can't do nothing, but I do not want to do tampons again because those suckers are expensive as heck. I did the math, okay, and I need to save all of my coins. So yes, Diva cup or bust. So that's it for now. Bye. Okay, back at it. So I didn't get to finish out the first Diva Cup review because I don't know what happened. I just didn't finish it. And then I said, you know what, let me just wait until my next cycle, which actually just wrapped up as of yesterday. So the one thing I really wanted to work at, like I stated in my the first time I did the video, was the insertion of the Diva cup. So when I did it at first, I used to leak a lot. Now my period's on average about four to five days, and then it's done. I used to leak a lot. So I really wanted to perfect that. And then, so when this cycle happened, I'm like, you know what, I'm gonna do it. So what I did, the first day I put it back, really, I put it up, I inserted it super far, like farther than normal when I did it. So when I inserted it way up there, I had like the worst cramps. I mean, I had cramps shooting down my leg. Like I couldn't move. I normally have cramps like on the first 2 days, like I said before. On the first 2 days of my period is like crazy cramps, but this one I could barely move. My back was killing me. Like, I mean, crazy. So then I'm like, you know what? Maybe if I move this a little bit, it'll be better. And when I did that, it got better. Granted, I did take Midol too, which I normally do. It was good.
But then I'm like, okay, I really don't want to quit. I want to keep going. So I watched another video on YouTube from, I have notes down here. Her name is Sarah Tran. Girl, thank you, girl, because you saved me, girl. And she did like a different folding, inserting method. So that's different from what is on the instruction manual. So what she recommended, oh yeah, this is the cup, by the way, it's the cup bag. What she recommended was, you know, you fold it, push one side down like so, close it together, take your finger out, you know, so you want it to look like a whatever shape this is, okay? So then you insert it. So let's say this is your vaginal canal, okay? So you put it in there, okay? And it's easier to insert now that if it's like this, I found it super easy to go in, to insert it. Like when you do this, which is what I did my first cycle, my last cycle, I mean, didn't work. It was like, oh my God, I can't get it. The surface area is too big. But when you do it like this, it works for me. So you can try that if you're having issues. Okay, so you insert it in there, right? You get it up to the little pointy spot, right? You insert it in there. And then when you push down on the pointy part, like this, you hear it does that. And you can feel it. And I did it like until I felt that opening thing going on, okay? I did it until I felt that. So I did it and I was like, I didn't feel anything, or I didn't feel like it was opening well enough. I'll do it again. So, and then once you do that, you do that relaxed. I still was in the same position over the toilet. Squat down slightly away from the toilet. So then you contract your vaginal muscles. And at the same time, you push it up, okay? So you're probably gonna be like pushing like this, because only this can fit up there. Well, yeah, for an average person, like myself, you push it until you get to like your tailbone area, okay? Or until you get to, not too far up, but just past your tailbone, to where when you close your legs, you can't feel, it doesn't feel weird. All right. So when I did that, it was like, I didn't have any leaks. And like I said, I had a panty liner just to be on the safe side. I didn't have any leaks for, I want to say, almost all day. Towards the end though, like, then I started to get a little self-conscious and I went back to check. I still didn't have any leaks. I didn't have any leaks during the day when I did that. But when I went to sleep, I got up at like, I probably went to sleep around 10 o'clock, woke up at like 3 to use the bathroom, and I didn't put the light on or anything. I just did one of those bathroom with the lights off, did it down there. I didn't see any blood in the dark at that time, from what I can remember. I didn't feel any blood, I didn't see any blood, but in the morning when I woke up, I did leak, so I don't think that leak was from prior to me using the bathroom in the middle of the night. So I think it was when I peed, there was probably some shifting going on and then causing the leak in the morning. So, but then the next day when I woke up and I reinserted it the same way, didn't have any leak again for that day. So my next cycle, and I'll let you guys know, I'm going to do that inserting style, because I watched that video on the second, third day of my cycle. So I was already halfway gone, and I'm lazy. So I did keep my cup in for longer than what they tell you on the instructions manual. I had it in there for like a good, maybe 16 hours. Two of those days, I had it in there for 16 hours, because I was just out and really, I don't feel comfortable in people's bathrooms, and then I have to, like, do all of that in somebody else's bathroom. I'm not there yet. So, but didn't have that many, that much leak. Like, I didn't leak at all. And if even, I just kind of psyched myself out, like, oh my God, I think I need to go home now to take this out. And, you know, I'm still on the Diva Cup. I will use it again for my next cycle. And I'm probably going to use it again for the cycle after that, because Sarah Tran, it took her 5 cycles. So I'm happy that I caught it on my second cycle, on the inserting method. I think that was one of the biggest challenges, is my inserting method. And when I tell you guys, I was cramping, boy, I was cramping. Like, I could not move. Like, if I do this, it's pain. It was like never before. Okay. So try it. And it was like $24 at Target. I was so kind of upset. It was $24 at Target after I bought it for $36 a month before at Walmart. But you know what? I'm not going to be upset, because I still got my boxes of tampons that I have not used, and I didn't have to go and buy another one. See, I saved a whole whopping $6, $6 to $7 during the cycle, because every cycle I buy a new box. So, and the surprise. What's the surprise? Yay! Yes, I'm going to med school, but I'm going to save that for the next vlog. So like and subscribe. You know, really basic. Like, I'm in my bathroom right now because I like the lighting in here. And we're supposed to close this. Better lighting. I like the lighting in here, you know. And I have locks, you know. My hair's locked. So that could be another video for another day if you're interested. And I'm a lazy lock. I'm a lazy locker. So everything I do it lazily. I don't know if that's a word, but I know I do it without effort. Okay? Very, very effortlessly, you know. Slaying effortlessly. Okay, let me stop. I would have married you, I would wait for you. I would have married you, I would break for you.